it by love. Bible says, let us not love in word or tongue, but in deed and truth. Now, if you don't tell people the truth, you can say, I love you all you want, but you don't really love them. Jesus said, as many as I love, I rebuke and chasten. Be zealous, therefore, and repent. The Bible says, open rebuke is better than secret love. Jesus said, greater love has no man than this, but that a man laid down his life for his friends. Have you laid down your life for Jesus Christ? You love Jesus Christ? You can't even stop masturbating. Jesus said,
and he told you to come out here and judge every single one of us.
Yes, he said, go in all the world.
And he told me, God, you're amazing. If God tells you you're psychotic.
God shall be damned. Jesus said, I'm not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. You can't call sinners to repentance without talking about sin. I'm telling you, your sin will send you to hell if you repent.
How do you know I sin? You don't know nothing about me.
Well, are you a sinner?
No. Are you a sinner?
Oh, you're so
free? You judge me?
So you're like me. You're free from sin.
You're holy.
Who are you to judge me?
You're like God.
So
what sins are you committing?
They're none of your business. God, they're my business. Me and God.
Well, Jesus said, if you love me, keep my commandments.
Out here telling us what to do and how to do it.
Oh, Jesus did that.
Are you Jesus?
You're not God.
I have a question for you. If a homosexual dies in their sin, what's the Bible say is going to happen to them?
I am a homosexual.
Oh, then you're not a Christian.
Yes, she is.
You're a child of the devil. You're a child.
No, I'm not.
Homosexuals are children of the devil. You can't be a homo and a Christian at the same time.
Yes, you can.
Jesus will make the homo go straight. Jesus will make the feminist submit. Jesus will make the drunkard go sober.
First book of Matt.
To repent.
Thou shalt not shower bullshit.
Love your wife as your own body, as Christ loved
Yes, thank you. And that doesn't mean a man just running over a woman. Jesus doesn't do that.
Well, see, you need to find a good man to put you in your place, a man that loves God, a man that doesn't sin,
a man
that reads his Bible, a man that prays, a man that loves his mama, a man that doesn't sin. That man will be worth submitting to.
Everybody.
Where in the Bible? Where did Jesus preach?
One of the things that the Lord hates is looking down on.
Where did Jesus preach?
How do you live?
Masturbation.
Jesus.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 27. Jesus said, "You have heard it said of old time, thou shalt not commit adultery. But I say unto you, whosoever looketh on a woman with lust has already committed adultery with her in his heart. And if your right eye offends you, pluck it out."
I know he was looking at me a minute ago.
Be more profitable than I, Paul.
And I'm having
two eyes.
That's what I'm saying. That's why he needs to cover.
For the fire's not quenched. And he goes, the next verse says, if your right hand offends you, cut it off and cast it from you. Be more profitable than I, like Paul.
I'm
having two hands. And he's to run in hell. For the fire's not quenched. What are you doing when you're masturbating? You're lusting after somebody. I'm not accusing you of sex in general. I'm a fake person. I'm not accusing anybody.
How come you still have
if the shoe fits, wear it. If it doesn't, don't.
Where's that at in the Bible?
Original sin is not taught in the Bible. What's that? Sex inside of a Christian marriage between a male and female is not sin. The Bible says marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled, but whoremongers and adulterers God will judge.
She said, look at his stomach.
Excuse me.
Right.
Then why'd you look at her stomach and say she was a whore then?
I told
thank
her to put
you.
Her shirt down. I didn't call her a whore.
You yes, you did. You have a fucking camera. You have it on camera.
Don't look at her and say she's a
whore. You had it on camera.
So did you not just sin? You lied about what you said.
Thank you. You lied. They have it on camera.
Out of business.
Right. There you go. That's
how can
what
you put
I
a
said.
Business out of business unless you're running the same business? Thank you.
Excuse me.
Yeah. You called me a hypocrite on that. That's a lie. You said I'm
business. You're the reason why the strip clubs are going out of business.
Have
you been to
strip
clubs? Cover up yourself.
Yeah, Romans 6:21. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God. It doesn't matter. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. So if you were not a sinner, you would be immortal. You're gonna die.
I am mortal because I did sin.
You don't sin. No, you're judging people.
No. 1 Peter 4:18 again, for the umpteenth time, says if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear?
After they die.
Are you righteous or are you ungodly?
No one is righteous.
Oh, the Bible says, the Bible said 1 John 3:7, little children, let no one deceive you. He that does righteousness is righteous, even as he is righteous. First, morally, yes.
Except for Jesus.
I got you. I apologize. Let me finish here and I'll get back to you. You're next. I apologize.
I'm
First John,
now you want to be nice.
1 John 2:29 says, if you know that he is righteous, you know that everyone that does righteousness is born of him. So if you're born again, you're righteous, and the proof that you're righteous is that you do righteously.
And
you live righteously. You live holy.
Right,
you obey God.
Not living righteous right now.
The Bible said Jesus
you're turning
Christ
people away from
is
God.
The author of eternal salvation unto all them that obey him. The Bible said, 2 Corinthians 5:21, he has made him to be sin for us who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. If you're a sinner, God doesn't answer your prayers.
Yes, he does.
The Bible said, First Peter.
I love that one.
Jesus is a liar, then, according to you.
Whoa! He just said Jesus is a liar.
According to you.
Thinking right now, since it's according to me.
Jesus said, Matthew 5:48, be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father in heaven is perfect.
He made all of us in his image, and none of us are perfect.
For the Son of Man that he should repent, the Bible says, be holy as I am holy. The Bible says God's not called us unto uncleanness, but unto holiness. The Bible said without holiness, no man will see the Lord.
We were born into a world of sin.
Well, you had a choice. You chose to sin. Now choose to stop sinning and obey God.
No, Adam and Eve chose sin. We are born into sin because of them. You were born into sin, just like the rest.
If Adam and Eve sinned and they weren't born sinners, you don't need a sin nature to sin. They chose to sin.
But
the
everybody
sin
has
reason
to
you
Adam
choose
Eve
to sin.
Because
you're selfish.
How do you know I
sin? Because you're a sinner.
How?